Hi.
Anirudh call near center 6 feet away. Processing. 31-year-old man with brown hair looking happy.
I've been programming since high school. And in my own world, I thought I was good at programming. But when I reached Dalhousie, I suffered the biggest dose of imposter syndrome. When I saw the research done by the professors, the PhD students, the students in my own classroom and undergraduate, I realized there's so much more to learn. So at Dalhousie, I heard about this thing called a hackathon, basically a 48-hour programming event where people get together, think of an idea, and go build it. And eventually, in my professional career, I would go to these hackathons, build hacks, and then try to get funding for them. Eventually winning the planet's largest hackathon 4 times with my teams. In fact, Seeing Air started at a hackathon. Seeing Air is an app on the iPhone, which uses computer vision and artificial intelligence to describe the world around you. And this is targeted for the blind and low vision community, and has quickly become the de facto app used by this community around the world. Imagine you're at the shop and you're paying the cashier with cash, and cash currency is usually inaccessible. Well, you just hold the cash currency in front of you and the app will tell you right then and there. So you are more confident and you can trust what the cashier gave you back. Or when you're at a restaurant and you have a menu in front, without asking for the waiter, you can use this to read the menu on your own and order food just like anyone else. The biggest motivation is to witness small barriers in life getting removed. And with each success, people getting the confidence going from, can I do this, to what else can I do? When I witnessed the amazing effect of what artificial intelligence can bring for the blind community, I kept asking what more can be done and what is still unmet. What are the limitations of AI at this point in time? And for that, I looked at how Aira could take care of all the things that AI still cannot do. And gradually we can train AI to do more, more and more day by day.
Hi, thanks for calling Aira. What would you like to do today?
Hi, Kira. So Aira connects a blind person wearing a smart glass or a smartphone with a remote professional agent by live streaming the video from the camera to the agent. And this agent is then able to describe the world back to the blind person. So the blind person knows their environment and can do whatever they like. And it's incredible to see people use it from the ordinary to the extraordinary, all the way from simple things like going to a grocery store and shopping independently without assistance, going to an airport and navigating on your own without having to ask for assistance, or all the way to blind photographers, blind marathon runners, and even a blind driver. It's amazing what technology can do as a tool for people when they decide to be independent.